All right. I want to talk about a very controversial subject, about Lucifer and the New Age. I know there are going to be a lot of people who want to hear Jordan Maxwell talking about Lucifer and the New Age, because I have been charged by Christians with being a Luciferian and a New Ager. So I thought, well, let's look at Lucifer and the bringer of the New Age. Let's see what this is really all about that I'm being charged with. Everyone has heard stories about the end of the world, and there's a lot of talk about the New Age, but very few people realize that both subjects are the same. The New Age is the end of the world. Let's start with the end of the world first. Then we'll go to the origins of the New Age, and then to the Christian Church's view of the New Age. And then we'll end up with Lucifer. So let's start with the end of the world. There's a lot of talk about the end of the world now. There have been lots of books and a lot of articles talking about how will the world end. The atomic bomb was going to bring the end of the world. The rapture, this is actually, hasn't even happened yet, October 21st, 2011. These people are saying the end of the world is coming in October 21st, the end of the world. So here's these young Christians are preparing for the rapture. There's another Christian publication, How Can You Survive the End of the World? Just to give you an idea about how much the Bible has to say about the end of the world. Here's 13 computer files I have that is crammed filled with quotes, documents on the New Age, the New World, Lucifer. Here's 23 more computer files on Bible references on the New Age, Lucifer, and the end of the world. Lots and lots of computer files and thousands of references. But so there's a total of 36 computer files I have with over 200 quotes from Bibles and Bible reference works. Of course, I will only be able to show a few highlights just to give you an idea about the subject. First, when we discuss the subject of the end of the world, we need to go back to where the idea came from, and that is the Judeo-Christian Bible. The Holy Bible is the source from which today, we modern day, get the idea of the end of the world. So, we'll take the New Testament King James Version, and in the book of Matthew, Jesus is talking about, it says, Jesus is saying to his apostles, the enemy that sowed them is the devil. And the harvest is the end of the world. In Matthew 28, in the New Testament, Jesus' words are famous, actually famous words that most Christians will recognize. Matthew 28, 19 and 20, where Jesus is telling his apostles, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And Jesus goes on to say, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I command you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. Even to the end of the world. Interesting also is another scripture in the Bible. Jesus talks about something he calls the regeneration. The footnotes say it means a renewal or a recreation of the whole social order on earth, and then adds, that will be God's kingdom. So the scripture has Jesus talking about a regeneration or a renewal or recreation of the whole social order on earth, and that will be God's kingdom. Well, here it is in the scriptures. It says, and Jesus, reading the scripture at the top, it says, and Jesus said unto them, verily I say unto you, that ye have which ye who have followed me in the recreation or the regeneration. The bottom footnote says that the Greek word recreation or making new. The word occurs once again in Titus 3:5. There is reference to a new birth. Here, the recreation of the social order or the renewal of the earth. So it's an interesting term that the Bible has Jesus saying, that ye who have followed me in the regeneration. Regeneration is a Greek word, as I said, which means a recreation or a making new of a new recreated social order and a renewal on the earth. Now, we find other Bible translations when speaking about this recreation of the world's social order. It refers to it as, and these are different Bible translations that refer to the recreation of the world social order as a new world. For instance, in the Interpreter's Bible Dictionary, there's an article that says, quoting Jesus again, and Jesus said unto them, verily I say unto you, that which have followed me in the regeneration. Well, it goes on to give you a different translation of another Bible on the right-hand side. And it says, and Jesus said to them, truly I say to you, in the new world. So we see in the regeneration is also translated in the new world. So the promise has to do with a new world, literally a regeneration or a rebirth. Or a new heavens and a new earth. So, keep in mind that we're talking about the regeneration or the new birth of a new earth, which is called also a new world. Then, there is a reward. Well, the commentator goes on to say in the footnote that there is reward in the world to come. So the world to come, there will be rewards for people who follow Jesus. There will be a reward in the world to come, which is regeneration or a new world. So we have the New Century Bible Commentary, the book of the Gospel of Matthew. And in this it says, the promise has to do with a new world. Literally, regeneration, rebirth. And the age to come, there will be a new heavens and a new earth, a new and renewed creation. So, in the new world, or the regeneration, Josephus uses it as a restoration of the land of Israel. Jewish hopes await for a renewal of both the land and the entire earth, the entire world. Then it says on the bottom, the 12 disciples will share in the Son of Man's dominion in the new age. So the new world, regeneration, the new order, the new age. Seventh-day Adventist Bible Dictionary. Here's a Bible dictionary. You'll look up the word world, and it will tell you that the word world is generally a Greek word, aion, aeon. So when you see, I will be with you to the end of the world, it's actually a Greek word, aeon, which means age, a time, or A-E-O-N, aeon, meaning an age. So keep that in mind. I will be with you to the end of the world. No, I will be with you to the end of the aeon, the age. Of the New Testament words translated world, aeon, age considers the world from the viewpoint of time. Again, when you see the word in the New Testament where someone's talking about the coming world, it's actually, the word is aeon, the coming age.